All right, shalom, shalom, Yasharala. Back at it again. What another Lord with an edifying video through the spirit and the power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Machakwadash. Before I go any further, I want to give all honor and all glory and all praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Machakwadash. And next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders, the great millstone, who still go out there on the highways and hedges and feed us with 100% truth according to the Bible and Heruel. And Shalom, Labacharim, Wabarakim, Shaya Sharala, which is peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel in the Lashon Kodesh, the Hebrew tongue. And the name of this lesson is called E is Coming for You. Okay? E is coming for you, man. All right? But mainly referring to you other Israelite groups out here that are pushing these false doctrines on down to the average nigga out here, man. You see? And you ain't going to be protected by the Lord. So the first precept I'm going to grab is the book of 1 Peter, chapter 5, verse 8. Okay? And it says, be sober, be vigilant, which is talking about the men of the Lord. The word sober meaning clear-minded. Or pretty much being wise. If vigilant meaning careful, watchful, all right, to be on one's guard, right? And it says, because your adversary, the devil, which the word adversary meaning enemy, the devil, the great deceivers, Esau, Edom, or the so-called white people, beginning with their elites, the international banking families, all right, beginning with the Rothschilds, it says, as a roaring lion walketh about seeking whom he may devour, right, with his, first and foremost, with his philosophies, man. Because through his philosophies and his deceptions is our people going to walk into the ditch, man, which is, represents destruction. Okay? Our people are walking as a flock to the slaughter. All right? By them accepting to taking that right hook, or what the elder bishops call the spider juice, you know? They're walking to the path to destruction, because what's next? They're going to take the MOTB. And if they take that, it's not the, it's a sure destruction, man. You see, there's no turning back from that. All right. So now that was pretty much it on that. So now let's get the book of Revelation, man, because you know Esau Edom's coming, man. Now, although Esau Edom's also going to grab some of the men of the Lord, but it's a different story for the men of the Lord, because they're going to be protected, even if they got to get put to death. You know what I'm saying? The Lord might have it to where, like the big bro said, where you might be in the guillotine or you might be getting ready to get put to death. And the Lord already called your spirit back up to the spirit world, man. All right? And your flesh just going to, you know, be shot up or get your head chopped off. No, but you're already in the spirit world, man. That's mercy right there. That's going to happen to the men of the Lord. All right? So this is the book of Revelation 12, verse 12. Therefore rejoice ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Right, the heavens is talking about Esau, Edom's rule, man. And ye that dwell in them, you're all our people. All right? So live it up while you can, man. Enjoy the benefits that Esau, Edom gives you. You know, because this is the beginning of the sorrows right here. That moratorium, you see, a lot of people about to get evicted, man. You see? So slowly but surely, you know, the beginning of sorrows is about to be at hand. And it says, and ye that dwell in them, woe to the inhabitants of the earth, beginning with the elites, right? And of the sea, which the sea represents the people. For the devil, which is also the Edomites, beginning with the elites, is come down unto you, having great wrath through that new world order, right? And it says, because he knoweth that he have but a short time, right? The triumphant of the wicked is short, and they know it. So now they're like, all right, we got to speed these things up. The Lord, Yahweh, Bashi, Mashiach, is putting the spirit on them to speed things up, man. All right, so everybody that scoffed and scorned at the words of the Lord, that thought we was crazy, that what we're saying is not going to happen, you know, which is biblical prophecy. Now, you know, it's, you know, they're slowly but surely, you know, they're seeing it a little bit, man. All right, but the 2/3 of our people are gonna stay asleep until it's pretty much at their front door. All right, which that literally about to be at your front door, real, real soon. Okay, so now Matter of fact, let's go ahead and grab Matthew. Let's see what Lawyer Howard Shaw said. This is Matthew 24 and 21. This is Lawyer Howard Shaw speaking with a war eagle God, Jesus Christ, right? He was prophesying, right, about in these times that we're living in. And it says, for then shall there be great tribulation. Yeah, great tribulation, great hell, great calamities, right? Great chaos. Such as what not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be. So, right, so the times that we're living in now, man, this is going to be worse than any time in history, man. You can picture any type of time in history, all right, where it was a tragic or it was, how should I say, it was a horrific event. You know, this is going to overshadow all of them. All right, Lo Yahushua's prophesied about it. All right. Verse 22, it says, and except those days should be shortened, there shall no flesh be saved. Right, it's going to be so much death. That's how much destruction that the Lord's going to put the spirit on Esau even to bring, right? It says, but for the elect's sake, all right, those days shall be shortened. Right, because they're going to be delivered, man. All right. Esau, Edom, you know what I'm saying, is going to try to, how should I say, try to deceive the elect, but it's not gonna happen. They're not gonna bow down. All right, they're not gonna give up their faith in Yahweh Shimei Hashai to please Esau, Edom. All right, or their women, or whoever else that is down with the Esau, Edom system, man. All right, but he's coming, man. All right, he's coming. He's coming in full force. So, as a matter of fact, let's get Jeremiah, the 30th chapter. That's what this lesson is all about. All right. This is Matthew chapter 30, verse 7. And it says, alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. Who is Jacob? Jacob. Are you Israelites? Okay, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native American Indians, and you Israelite foreigners who look like the other heathen nations, but whose father's seed line go back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, man. All right, this is going to be your trouble, man. All right? During the time of martial law, which martial, it goes back to warlike, law meaning decree. So the Lord's going to have these warlike, you know, soldiers, man, coming in and doing you jakes in, man. They ain't going to have no pity or mercy. And it says, but he shall be saved out of it, meaning the elect. All right. And also during the time of Jacob's trouble is going to be, you know, that force right hook, man. Or that force spider juice. All right. So, yeah. So, hey, we're beginning to see it now, man. And it's only going to get worse. Everybody think it's going to get better. It ain't going to get no better, man. It says in Ezekiel 7 and 25, destruction cometh, and they shall seek peace, and there shall be none, man. There ain't no peace out here, man. They shutting the society down again. All right? So now let's get the book of Daniels. Then we're going to close it out. Daniels, the 12th chapter. Daniel chapter 12, verse 1. And at that time, which is very soon, future prophecy, shall Michael stand up, right? The head archangel, right? Mayaka Allah, all right? And it says, which is a war angel, right? And it says, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people, which is the elect of the nation of Israel, all right? In these times, it says that there shall be a time of trouble, which I just read, such as never was since there was a nation even to that time, which I explained that earlier. And at that time, thy people shall be delivered, right? The elect, when Yahushua returns with those chariots, the so-called UFOs, to beam us up if we be of the elect, all right? And it says, because that word deliver goes back to rescue, man. We're being rescued from our enemies, man, all right? And it says, everyone that should be found written in the book, right? The book of life, and only the elect is going to be in that, all right? So, we're going to be delivered by that, you know, by that right hook or that spider juice and an MOTB, All right, and be protected in these evil days that we're pretty much living in now. All right. So Lord's window is edifying through the spirit. Pavi Yahweh Shimei Shah. Lord's will until next time. I say Shalom.